नमस्कार। सो दिस इज अवर फिफ्थ मॉड्यूल इंडस्ट्रियल कंट्रोल सिस्टम्स। सो दिस इज वेरी इम्पोर्टेंट टॉपिक इन दिस सब्जेक्ट। सो इन इंडस्ट्रीज और इन प्रोसेसेस, सो कंट्रोल सिस्टम्स आर वेरी इम्पोर्टेंट। सी हियर, इफ देयर यूनिट ऑपरेशन, देयर इंटीग्रेशन विथ अदर प्रोसेसेस एंड कंट्रोल वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी। In this chapter, we are going to discuss the difference between process industries and discrete manufacturing industries, then continuous industries versus discrete control industries. Then also, we will discuss the computer process controls, forms of computer process controls, then discrete control using PLCs, PLC controllers, its architecture, ladder logics, then programmings of different types of logic gates. So all these things we are going to study in this module. So what is industrial control system? How it is defined? So industrial control is the automatic regulation of unit operations and their associated equipment, as well as the integration and coordination of the unit operations into the larger production system. So in this way the industrial control is defined. So it is the automatic regulation of unit operations and their associated equipment, as well as the integration and coordination of the unit operations into larger production system. So what do you mean? Unit operation, usually unit operation refers to a manufacturing operations. So unit operation can also apply to material handling or other equipment or other operations also. So let us discuss different types of industries and its differences. So I have taken these slides from from internet. So it is a Pearson's Education Incorporation, so it is a copyright material, and this data is from Automation Production System and Computer Integrated Manufacturing by P. Grewal. So M.P. Grewal. So this book is available in our institute. So I referred these notes, which is readily available on internet. So, and this book is also useful. This book is available in our institute also. So, what is process industry and discrete manufacturing industry? So, process industries, production operations are performed on amount of material. So, material like liquid, gases and powders, means the milk industry. So, amount of material is production, milk industry, sugar industry. So these are process industries. Many chemical industries are process industries, as the production operations are performed on amounts of material, the liter, the ton or kg. Whereas discrete manufacturing industries means production operations are performed on quantities of material, the number of parts are produced. So the vehicle manufacturing, so batch production, or any part production, or the fabrication. So unit products, number of products are calculated there in terms of number, not in terms of amount, that is a kilogram or liter. It is not calculated in amount, but it is calculated in terms of quantities. Then it is called as discrete manufacturing industries. Okay, this is major difference. So accordingly, you are going to implement or use the industrial control system. Then, let us discuss some terms used in industrial control system. So, there are some parameters you are going to measure or consider during automation. And there are some variables. Okay, so the parameters are input to the processes. Parameters are input to the processes. After process, there are some output, the variables So outputs of the processes are variables. Then there are some continuous variables and parameters. Continuous process variables and parameters means they are uninterrupted as time proceeds. Continuous it is going on. Means continuous variables or parameters also considered to be analog. Means that can take on any value within a certain range. They are not restricted to a discrete set of values. Means continuous variables and parameters. Now, discrete variables and parameters means this can take on only certain values within a given range. It is not a continuous, it is a discontinuous, or it is interrupted as time proceeds. Such means see, so in case of process system, there are input processes, parameters are considered. The output of the process, there are variables. These variables are either continuous or discrete. Now, let us see the categories of discrete variables and parameters. You know, the switch on and off. Then they can take either of two possible values, on or off, or 1 or 0, binary codes, that is 1 or 0, etc. Discrete, other than binary, they can take on more than two possible values, but less than an infinite number of possible values. Also, there are pulse data. A train of pulses that can be counted is also called as discrete variables or parameter example. This is also example of discrete variables and parameters. Okay, it is not a continuous, but you can count it, number of counts. Okay. See, this figure shows the difference between continuous and discrete variable parameters. So, this curve shows the analog, continuous analog variable with respect to time. Okay, the variables or parameter values are continuous with respect to time. There is no any interruption. So, in this way you can show this curve. Whereas these blocks here, this is discrete value. So, discrete variable other than binary. So, here no rectangle or no any object means zero, and there is a line means there is a 1. So, 0, 1, 0, 1. Oh, these are pulse datas on discrete binary variables and discrete variable other than binaries. Okay, these are discrete variables and parameter representation. Let us discuss types of controls. So, just there are two basic types of variables and parameters in processes. What are two types? Continuous control and discrete control. So, continuous control variables and parameters are continuous and analog. And discrete control variables and parameters are discrete, mostly binary discrete values. So, usually the objective of continuous control is to maintain the value of an output variable at a desired level. So, parameters and variables are usually continuous and similar to operation of a feedback control system. So, most continuous industrial processes have multiple feedback loops. Examples of continuous processes are control of the output of chemical reaction that depends on temperature, pressure, or any other parameter. So, the control of position of cutting tool relative to work part in a CNC machine tool. So, these are some examples of continuous processes. And what is the objective? So, parameters and variables are usually continuous, similar to operation of feedback control system. So, most continuous industrial processes have multiple feedback loop. Its objective is to maintain the value of output variable at desired level. Then there are different types of continuous process control. So first we'll discuss the continuous process control, and then we'll discuss the discrete process control. Okay. So there are different types of continuous process control. So regulatory control, feed forward control, steady state optimization, adaptive control, online search strategies, and other specialized techniques like expert systems, neural network, etc. So these are different types of continuous process control systems. So let us discuss first regulatory control. So what is the objective of regulatory control? Objective of regulatory control system maintains process is to maintain process performance at a certain level or within a given tolerance band of that level. So it is appropriate when performance relates to a quality measure. It is not related to quantity, but it is a quality measures. So performance measure is sometimes computed based on several output variables. Performance measure is called index of performance, which is denoted by IP. So problem with regulatory control is that an error must exist in order to initiate control action. If there is error, then you can take a initiate control action. If there is no error, you cannot take initiate any control action. Okay. So this is about regulatory control. What is the objective? To maintain process performance at a certain level or within a given tolerance band of that level. And this is a quality measure, not a quantity measure. Okay, this is about regulatory control. In figure, you can see there is a input parameters. So process receives input parameters. It processes and provides output variables. Then the variables, output variables are measured and it is sent to controller. Controller compare the measured variables with the desired variable, and considering the performance target level, there are some signals given to the input parameter. And at the input parameter, so adjustments to the input parameter so that to achieve the desired output. So once the output you are getting, then finally the performance measurement is taken and the index of performance is again this measured and the feedback is given to the controller. So it is a continuous regulating process. If any error is there, it is rectified and or action is taken by the controller and it is adjusted. Input is adjusted so that the desired output variables you can achieve. Okay, this is the regulatory control in industrial control system. Is it clear? The next type of control, continuous control. This is the example of continuous control. So second type of continuous control is feed forward control. Feed forward control. So the objective of feed forward control is anticipate the effect of disturbances that will upset the process by sensing and compensating for them before they affect the process. What is the objective? To anticipate the effect of disturbances that will upset the process by sensing and compensating for them before they affect the process. Mathematical model captures the effect of the disturbance on the process. Complete compensation for the disturbance is difficult due to variations imperfections in the mathematical model and imperfections in the control actions. So usually, so this is combined with regulatory control. This feed forward control is combined with regulatory control. So regulatory control and feed forward control are more closely associated with process industries. So here, in case of feed forward control, the objective is to anticipate the effect of disturbances that will upset the process by sensing and compensating for them before they affect the process. And these are used in combined with regulatory control. Okay. See, you can see the diagram for feed forward control combined with feedback control. So feed forward control, it measures the disturbances and in advance it gives the feed forward control elements to the controller so that the adjustment is made to the input variable considering the disturbances. Along with it will also receive feedback from output variables and also it receives the index of performance. It shows the combination or combining of feed forward control and regulatory control. By combining the result or the signals from the feed forward element and measure variables and index of performance, the controller takes an action and there are adjustments are done in input parameters and processes are carried out and variables you will get the output variables. Okay, so this is a second type of continuous control system. Then third is steady state optimization. The class of optimization techniques in which the process exhibits some important characteristics. So first, well-defined index of performance, that is IP. So known relationship between process variables and index of performance. Then system parameter values that optimize industrial index of performance can be determined mathematically. It is an open loop system. And it is an optimization technique includes differential calculus, mathematical programming, etc. So in steady state open loop optimal control system, so this figure explains the input variables, input parameters, then processes and output variables and performance measure takes place. Before that, so there is an index of performance and mathematical model of process and industrial index of performance. Then algorithm to determine the optimum input parameter values. So the all inputs are taken and accordingly the input parameters are changed and process is carried out and you will get the output variable and performance measure. But no any index of performance, that is so the output variables are not considered, the signal, the feedback is not used here, but index of performance is used and mathematically the calculations, so theoretical calculations, so theoretical adjustments made in the input parameter so that it will get desired output. Okay, this is about the steady state or open loop optimal control systems used in industrial control system. So this is a third type of continuous control system. Okay, in next lecture we will see few more types of continuous control system like adaptive control systems and other types of control systems. Okay, if you have any doubt you can write in a comment box or we will discuss these doubts in our next session. Thank you. Thank you very much.